So hello everyone, in this video we'll do the daily current affairs analysis of 28th October 2021. So the first topic which we will discuss is about the Asian Development Bank, ADB. So it is from GS paper 2 and the topic is international relations and health related issues. So why it is in the news? The Indian government has applied for a loan from the Asian Development Bank and the Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, AIIB, to purchase up to $667 million of the COVID-19 vaccines. The Manila-based ADB and the Beijing-based AIIB, where China and India are the largest shareholders, are in the process of processing the loan. So the background of this information, this news item, the vaccine will be purchased by the government of India through a competitive process and the ADB will regulate the procurement process and process it under ADB's APVAX or the Asia Pacific Vaccine Access Facility. So about the ADB. It is a regional development bank. It was established on 19 December 1966. It has headquarters in Manila, Philippines. So it is an official observer of the United Nations. Who can be its members? The bank welcomes members of the United Nations Economic and Social Commission for the Asia and the Pacific, UNSCAP, former Asia and the Middle East Economic Commission or ECAF, and non-regional countries also. So the ADB now has 68 members, 49 of them are from within Asia. So voting rights in the ADB. It is modeled close to the World Bank and has a voting system based on the same weight mechanism, where votes are distributed proportionally to members' financial contributions. As of 31 December 2019, the five largest ADB shareholders are Japan and United States, each with 15.6% shares, the People's Republic of China 6.4%, India 6.3%, and Australia 5.8%. Roles and responsibilities of ADB, Asian Development Bank. So it contributes to poverty alleviation in Asia and the Pacific through inclusive economic growth, sustainable environmental growth, and regional integration. This is done through investments in the form of loans, grants, and information sharing in infrastructure, healthcare services, financial and public administration programs, helping countries prepare for the impact of climate change or better management of their natural resources and other areas. So the prelims hotlink topics are about the Asian Development Bank, grants and loans by the Asian Development Bank, its members and its voting process. So source of this news is The Hindu. Next is, what is the Pegasus snooping issue? So it is from GS paper 2 and topic is right to privacy versus national security. So why it is in the news? Emphasizing that state power to act on behalf of national security cannot completely be on the cost of compromising the right to privacy of citizens, the Supreme Court has appointed a specialist committee of experts headed by former Supreme Court Judge R.V. Ravindran to investigate allegations that the central government used Israeli software Pegasus to spy on citizens. So what is the problem? Petitioners have complained about the misuse of spyware software Pegasus by the government of India to get hold of their personal information that directly infringes on the privacy of citizens, which is a fundamental right under Article 21 of the Indian Constitution, as declared by the Honorable Supreme Court in the case Puttaswamy case 2017. So what is the background? Continued use of spyware Pegasus in India, which is made by an Israeli company that sells it to only governments around the world, has been confirmed by various non-official reports. Also, it is alleged that the Pegasus software has apparently been updated and now comes with new monitoring capabilities. So what is Pegasus? It is a spyware tool developed by an Israeli company, NSO Group. It is used to spy on people through their mobiles. Pegasus works by sending an exploit link, and when the target uses user clicks on the link, a malicious computer program or a software code is installed on the user's phone, which allows to do the surveillance of the user. Once Pegasus is installed, the attacker has full access to the target user's phone. What can Pegasus do? Pegasus can retrieve targeted personal data, including passwords, contacts, calendar events, text messages, and live voice calls from popular mobile messaging apps. The target's phone camera and microphone can be turned on to capture all activities close to the phone, thus increasing the range of surveillance. So the prelims hotlink topics are about spyware, about Pegasus, differences between spyware, malware, and Trojans. So the source of this news article, news is Indian Express. Next is amendments made to the registration of Birth and Deaths Act 1969. So it is from GS Paper 2 and topic is government initiatives. So why it is in the news? The Ministry of Home Affairs has proposed amendments to the Birth and Deaths Registration Act 1969, which will enable it to keep records of registered births and deaths at the national level. At present, the registration of birth and death is done at the state level by an official appointed by the respective state government. Need for the information may be used to update the population register and the electoral register, as well as to update the citizens' details in Aadhaar card, ration card, passport, and driving license, thus reducing the chances of multiplicity of data and thereby enhancing its authenticity. So the proposed amendments are, it is proposed that the chief registrar, which is appointed by the states, will keep the unified records at the state level and integrate them with the national level data, which is maintained by the Registrar General of India. So the amendments will mean that the center will act as a repository of all the collected data. Under the proposed amendments, special sub-registrars shall also be appointed in the event of a disaster. So what are the benefits of birth and death registration? A birth certificate is a child's first right and is the first step in determining who he or she is. So the following mandatory usage of birth and death certificates has emerged. Admission to schools as proof of working age, for proof of age in marriage, establish age for registration purposes, establish age for insurance purposes, to register with the National People's Register, National Population Register, NPR, production of compulsory death certificate for the purpose of inheriting property and claiming compensation from insurance companies and other companies. So the prelims hotlink topics are Registrar General of India, appointment and duties, IMR, infant mortality rate, and MMR, maternal mortality rate, current trends. What are the current trends? So source of this news is this article from the mha.gov.in website. You can read it to get a better understanding about the topic. So next is about the Agni 5 missile. So it is a prelims specific topic. So India has successfully tested the Agni 5 nuclear missile, Agni 5 intercontinental range ballistic missile, ICBM, was developed by the Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, and Bharat Dynamics Limited. It weighs around 50,000 kilograms and its length is around 7.75 meter with a diameter of around 2 meters. A 1500 kilogram warhead will also be mounted on three-dimensional oil-powered rocket boosters. So the missile would be able to travel all over Asia, Europe, and parts of Africa. India has already conducted 7 missile tests till now, more than 5,000, which covers an area of more than 5,000 kilometers wide. So it is the source of this article news is this article from the economictimes.indiatimes.com website. So next is, what is the Knock Every Door campaign? So it is a prelims specific topic. So the Department of Health plans to launch a Har Ghar Dastak Knock Every Door campaign in low vaccinated districts across the country to encourage people to get their COVID-19 jab. So this news article is taken from the Hindu. हिंदू. सो नेक्स्ट इज द इंटीग्रेटेड टीचर एजुकेशन प्रोग्राम. इट इज ऑल्सो अ प्रीलिम्स स्पेसिफिक टॉपिक. सो द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन ऑन वेडनेसडे अनाउंस्ड अ 4-year इंटीग्रेटेड टीचर एजुकेशन प्रोग्राम ITEP which provides 2 major qualifications that will be required for the employment of school teachers by 2030 according to the National Education Policy NEP 2020. As a pilot project in 2022-2023, the program will initially be offered at 50 selected multidisciplinary institutions across the country. Admission to the program will be done by the National Testing Agency and through the National Common Entrance Test (NET). So this news article is taken from Indian Express. So while you study this, you should also study about the National Education Policy. What are its various provisions? How that policy has evolved from the previous policies? What are some of the very good the provisions mentioned in that, and what are various issues in implementing those provisions, and how can the government proceed on that? How we can learn from the global best initiatives of various other countries which have excelled in the education field, particularly in improving the teacher teaching methodologies. Okay, you should also analyze that. It is very important from the mains point of view, because in mains 2020 a couple of questions both in GS paper 2 and also in GS paper 4 were asked on the National Education Policy. So it is one of the very important topics that you must study in very thorough and holistic manner, and must analyze it from various dimensions. Okay, so that's what UPSC expects from you. It expects you to be a very well-read candidate when he or she sees a particular news in a newspaper, he or she does a very thorough analysis that what are the various provisions related to that, why is it in the news, and what are the related topics or the related keywords of that particular news which are related to that, either directly or indirectly. So that analysis you have to do on your own. You have to use internet extensively for that. It will help you in that a lot. So thanks a lot for watching the analysis video. Have a nice day.